Hey guys, what is up? Welcome back to my channel. Today's video is going to be a Q&A, as you can tell by the title. I have some really fun questions, more like on the, I don't know, you guys already know what my Q&As are like. I don't spill any tea, I don't really get into any drama or super personal stuff, but there are some really good questions in there, so I'm excited. I think it's been a while since I last did a Q&A. I can't remember. I'm gonna start off with an easy question, and this is something that I actually get DMs about all the time, and that is where I get my jewelry. All my jewelry is from the M Jewelers. This is a little, it's like a round gold disc and it has a letter D on it. I wear it every single day. And these are the medium Ravello hoops. I also have the large version of this, and I have the small version of this. They're just really good quality. And I've had them for a really long time, so highly recommend. I'll leave it in the description box below. So when I put up this question box on my Instagram story, I answered a few of them on that day. I was like walking to work, and I answered them like live. And one of the questions was, what is your advice for making genuine friends in the industry after moving to New York? This is another question that I get a lot, and it's something that I notice that people really struggle with, is just finding their people in the city. To be honest, like, I didn't end up meeting the girls that I'm best friends with now until about a year and a half after I moved here. That doesn't mean that I didn't have friends in the beginning, because I did, but they weren't my like lifelong friends. They were just friends that I met through either my boyfriend at the time, or just people that I knew from the agency. In terms of like actually meeting people, I think, I don't know, I didn't really go looking for my friends. And I think friendships and relationships are very similar in that way. Like, if you go looking for them, you're not gonna find the right people. So I think the right people come into your life at the right time. And I think that if you just stay true to yourself and be genuinely you, you'll attract the people that are right for you. For example, the way that I met Shivani and Renee and like that whole group of girls was really random, because Shivani and I had already been following each other on Instagram because we had the same agency. And then we ran into each other at a casting, and she was like, oh, are you going away this weekend? I guess we had mutual friends who were all going to the Hamptons for a weekend, and I had been invited. And I was like, yeah, I'm gonna come. I don't really know anybody, but I'm glad to know that you're going. Little did I know that I was gonna meet that group of girls that weekend. And then other friends that I've met have been at work or through friends of friends, you know what I mean? So it kind of all happens when you stop looking for it and when you just do your thing. I don't know if that's good advice, but that's what happened to me. How to deal with mean girls in the industry. You just don't. At this point in my life, I just don't have time for that stuff. And to be honest, I feel like I've never really been the girl to like entertain that kind of behavior or attitude. I think out of all the people that I know in New York, I maybe know three people or three girls who don't really like me. There might be more and I just don't know. But you know, not everyone is gonna like you. And you're gonna go through things or go through experiences where someone ends up not liking you, whether you wanted that experience to happen or not. And that's just part of life. The girls who are like that and the girls who are mean and petty and say or do mean things, like, they're dealing with an inner struggle. They're probably jealous or insecure. At the end of the day, that sucks for them more than it sucks for me. You know what I mean? Bottom line, like, just don't tolerate it. Don't put up with it. Don't entertain it. Move on and focus on the people who are real and fun to be around and who treat you well. Why did you and your family travel so much when you were younger? Love your channel. Thank you. Thanks for watching my videos. So this is another question that I answered on my story, but my dad had a dream of moving to Canada. He had gone to Canada when he was a teenager. I think he was 19. And he fell in love with the country. My parents are both from Holland, by the way, if you didn't know. He was working at IBM in Holland, and then he had the opportunity to transfer to Canada, and that's when we moved to Calgary. We lived in Calgary for like 2.5 years, then we moved to Aruba, and he did a project there, Because we're Dutch and Dutch speaking, and Aruba used to be a Dutch colony, it was perfect. They needed a Dutch guy on that project, and my dad fit the bill. After a year, we moved back to Canada, but we moved to the opposite side of the country. We moved to Ottawa. I lived there for 3-something years. And then in the summer from grade 8 to grade 9, we moved to Toronto. And that's where my family is still today. They're like in the suburbs of Toronto. So yeah, basically we traveled because of my dad's job. My dad used to be a project manager for IBM. So he would have projects of like 2 to 3 years in length. That's why we traveled so much. How do you deal with a conception of superficiality that surrounds the modeling industry? This question is funny to me because I've had this happen, I don't want to say a lot, but I've had this happen a few times for sure, where someone has said to me like, oh, you're not what I expected you to be. I actually had this happen at Gloveworks before too, where someone was like, I didn't expect for you to be nice or like talk to me, or I kind of expected you to be like stuck up. I don't take that stuff personally because I guess they end up seeing who I really am and like the person that I am outside of my pictures and my Instagram, you know? But it is something that's unfortunate. I think that I forget about it because I know so many people in the industry, and I know the true character of people. The industry is a mixed bag, and you get people who are very superficial and materialistic and fake. But the people that I surround myself with in the industry, at least, are all wonderful people with a lot of depth, and they're very real and hardworking. I think this is also why I love having a YouTube channel and being able to vlog, is like being able to show people that we're just like everybody else. We do the same things. We also wake up looking like everybody else. You know, we go to the bathroom, we have our struggles, we have our emotions. I do recognize that it's hard to know that from the outside, especially when all you see is Instagram pictures. Or like final images from a photo shoot, for example. You know what it is? It's like if someone wants to get to know you and someone wants to see you for who you are, they will. Same thing goes for someone who wants to believe that all models are superficial. Like if they want to believe that, then they will. And it's not my job to change their mind. Like at the end of the day, those are not the people that I want to be surrounded by or the people that I want to talk to, you know what I mean? Are you interested in acting or working in the film industry? Yes, I actually am interested. My first 2 years that I was like modeling, it wasn't necessarily modeling really, it was more me auditioning for commercials and doing little acting jobs and stuff. And I definitely would be interested in getting back into it. I think that's something that's gonna happen in the near future. If you finish one day your full-time modeling career, will you still live the healthy slash strict lifestyle? And will you still look at your measurements? What is your mindset about that? Great question. For as long as I'll be modeling, I will always try and have the best physique that I can possibly have. I think in the last year especially, I've realized that I can do that without restricting myself like crazy. Like I found a workout that feels like a sport and that I love doing, but that also gives me really good results. In terms of food and stuff, I'm still able to eat fun things and do fun things. I'm also just in a mental space where I want to eat healthy and I want to feel good. I talk to you guys about this a lot. Like, I eat in a certain way because I want to feel a certain way, you know what I mean? So I think as far as my whole life goes, I will always want to feel my best, look my best, and do my best. But I do realize that probably one day, when I have kids, maybe my body is gonna change and it's gonna look different and it's not gonna be able to stay like this forever. But yeah, I'm not there yet, so I guess I will cross that bridge when I get there. Oh, I get this question a lot too. Why are you not walking any shows in New York Fashion Week? Is there any reason or is it your choice? I've never participated in New York Fashion Week, not one time. I've only done Toronto Fashion Week, maybe twice. I feel like there are girls with my body that walk New York Fashion Week and do all the castings, but to be honest, like I was working all of Fashion Week already. I had jobs booked and my regular clients were still shooting, and New York Fashion Week really is something for newer girls and girls that are coming from other countries, you know? Unless you're a seasoned New York Fashion Week walker. Like commercial girls like me and girls with regular clients and regular work, they don't really participate in Fashion Week fully. I know some friends who did like one or two shows. Most of the girls that walk New York Fashion Week, from my experience at least, are girls that are either coming here for the first time or girls that are real, like runway girls. So I guess it's a mix of like me not being the right fit and then also me just having other work that pays more money. Kudos to all the girls who do. Wow. To all the girls who do participate in New York Fashion Week, because it's not easy. You have a lot of castings, and especially in New York Fashion Week in February, it's cold outside, you're running around all day. It's like 2 weeks of serious running around, not sleeping, working really hard to maybe book a few shows. So I always have a lot of respect for the girls who participate in it because it's not easy. How many times slash week? No. How many times a week? Oh my gosh. How many times a week do you work out slash walk? As in like my walks that I take outside, do you do in order to notice results? So the workout thing is usually 4 to 5 times a week. The last few weeks I've been going to Gloveworks like 4 times a week. So that's kind of been my workouts. And then sometimes I'll go for cardio at the gym too. And then in terms of walking, I haven't been walking as much just because it's been cold out and we've had a lot of rain. But once it gets a little bit warmer and through the spring, summer, and fall, I won't necessarily be doing a morning walk every day, but I will definitely be walking to work, walking home from work, walking to all my castings and stuff. That's just another really great way to stay active and to get some exercise in. I have to add to that though, just because you said to notice results, for me, I have to eat right too to notice results. So you can do as much walking and as much working out as you want. But if you want to see results and you want to see a change, your lifestyle has to match. Okay, we're getting to the end of the video. I think I might answer one or two more questions. When it comes to fitness, what is your biggest struggle and how do you overcome it? I think that even though I've made a lot of progress in terms of food and diet and discipline when it comes to food and diet, I think that sometimes this is really only like at nighttime or on the weekends at night when I'm by myself, is to like practice that discipline. It's funny because when I'm out with friends and when I'm doing dinner with friends, my self-control is really great. I don't know why. Because usually for people it's like, oh, when they go out to dinner with friends and stuff, it's like goes out of control. But for me, my weakest moments are when I'm at home by myself and it's either a Friday or Saturday night. So yeah, I know that that's not really fitness, but food does play a big part in fitness. And I think that, you know, I will always be down for a workout. I will always make myself go either to Gloveworks or to the gym, but I won't always stick to my plans in terms of food. Like I said, like most of the time I have that under control now, but there's still moments where I'm like, okay, I could have been more disciplined here. I could have, there's really no other way to say it. I could have been more disciplined in this situation, you know? I really think that that is something that you just build over time and that discipline grows stronger over time. So I'm not worried about it and I don't want to restrict myself too much. If anything, I know by now that restriction and over-restricting myself just doesn't work for me. But if you're asking me what my downfall is, it would be self-discipline with food at nighttime on the weekends. So I think that's gonna be the last question. I hope you guys enjoyed this Q&A. I had so much fun filming it. Thank you guys for always sending such good questions and for participating. If you guys wanna participate in the next Q&A, definitely follow me on Instagram. The link will be in the description box below. I think I wanna start doing these more just because they feel like I'm really interacting with you guys and just answering more personal questions, you know? Give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it. Don't forget to subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you in the next one. Mwah.